Today, I rank every business in GTA Online from worst to best based on three things: how easy it is, how fun it is, and how much money you can earn. Starting off the list with the one and only document forgery business. The location of this business is all the way off the map where no one lives.
Where the f*** is everyone?
You barely make any money with this business. Basically, the more time you invest in this business, the more depressed you get. The only reason to get this business if you want to have the benefits with the nightclub and salvage yard. Otherwise, just skip this one. Because I'd rather have the MC clubhouse to make money, since it is right in the middle of the city. There's a better way to make money with the custom bike delivery, which makes 50k for a pretty simple mission. But besides that, you can't earn much money with the MC clubhouse, so that's why it's on this place on the list. Then the place where most of our beginning days started in the game is at the high-end apartments. In your high-end apartment, you got a planning board where you can start different heists. But the thing is, all these heists require 4 players to do it. And you already know if you're just playing a regular heist with one other player, it's already a lot of chaos. But if you're even doing it with 4 players, it's definitely going to take a long time. It is pretty fun doing these heists, but for the extremely long time that it takes and the payout not being well, it deserves this spot on the list. Talking about extremely long, for this business, you have to take a day off of your job. Because if you want to complete this heist, it's going to take you almost the entire day, which is the facility business. Inside the facility, you can start the Doomsday heist, which has a Act 1, Act 2, and Act 3. This is probably one of the hardest heists in the game, especially if you're a beginner in the game, you're completely screwed. You do need only one other player to start this heist, so it isn't like the high-end apartment where you need a total of 4 players. And the payout is over $1 million, so it's definitely worth doing it at least one time, since it's a pretty good challenge. Up next, we got the penthouse. You might be asking why this is so high on the list. It's because of one special thing that you get inside your penthouse, which is a private blackjack table. This is the only place where you can gamble 50,000 chips every time, which equals to $50,000. I'm not a gambling addict, but currently I do have over $1 million in casino chips purely from playing only blackjack. Next, we got 3 businesses which will combine into one group, which is the Green Stuff, Counterfeit Cash, and the Blue Lab. They are all around the same payouts, where the Blue Lab is the best one out of them. It is partly a passive business because if you own the master control terminal, you can resupply all the businesses in just one place. The thing that sucks with these businesses are the sell missions, where you will get multiple vehicles and sometimes you get even the slowest vehicles in the game, which makes this an extremely boring business. But with the next business, you have way more options to choose from. You can do this in your CEO office. The office is a pretty nice business where you will have an assistant sitting at the front desk where you can start one of the export mixed good missions which will pay you $50,000 in just a few minutes. But inside your office, if you go towards your computer in this place, you will have 2 other businesses inside here. Up first is the special cargo. This is a really straightforward business. All you do is steal CEO crates and bring it back to your business. The more CEO crates you have stolen, the higher your value will be. But a nice thing is that while you're doing this, you can also hire a staff member, which will also be stealing crates for you in the background. It's not a bad way to earn money, but it is really repetitive, so it can get boring real fast. However, with the second option in your CEO office, this method can be way more fun. Instead of stealing CEO crates, in this business, you'll be stealing different vehicles. It is pretty fun doing this, since you're just driving around different cars in the game, which you might not have driven before, and all you have to do is bring this car back to your business and eventually sell it to one of the buyers. You don't need to pay anything when you're stealing this vehicle, because when you're selling it eventually, everything will be straight up profit. Be careful though when you're selling the vehicle, because if you crash a lot and damage the car, the value will go down. If you are a bad driver, with the auto shop business, you can let your staff members sell the cars for you. You only have to modify the vehicle, give them the keys to the car, and they will handle the rest. So while they are selling the car in the background, you can start the contract mission over here at this planning board. There are several contracts that you can choose from, but the Union Depositary contract is the best one out of them, paying you almost $300,000 for just a simple mission. The payout for this contract is nice, but if you do one of the other contracts that are available, the payouts will come nowhere close to this one. Up next, we got the white lockup. The difference with this business than the other MC businesses is that this will give you the highest income out of all of them. You will still get multiple vehicles when doing the cell missions in the white lockup, but they are way simpler, which allows you to do them all solo. Then the next business, which I got located in the military base, is the hangar business. In the hangar business, you're going to source cargo as well, like the special cargo. But in the hangar, you have two options where you can either do this on land or you can do it in the air. The land missions are pretty easy to complete. And the great thing is if you source a specific type of cargo, you will get a bonus percentage on top of that. So you will earn even more money with it. But with the next business, you barely even have to be at that place. Because the bunker business is one of the slowest businesses in the game, you can literally do your own things while the bunker business is making you money in the background. When you do decide to sell the product, you will earn over $1 million. Additionally, you can also do the ammunition contracts, which will earn you an easy 50k for just a few minutes of work. Up next, we got the salvage yard, where we can also earn passive income from our safe by doing the tow truck missions. This is a pretty short mission for just a few minutes, and this alone will earn you around $30,000. But on top of that, you'll get $24,000 added daily into your wall safe. But there's one thing that only the salvage yard business has out of all the businesses in the game, which is by doing the steal vehicle missions. Every week you have three cars that you can steal. I will just always go for the most expensive one, which will be around 400k. Previously, I've also mentioned that with the document forgery business, you can literally claim this vehicle for just 10k, where the car usually would be worth millions of dollars. Now, the Klunkenbell farm raid is something you should definitely give a go. Because if you want to start this farm raid, there's no setup cost at all. A level 1 player can start this, and it is 100% solo friendly. The missions itself in the Klunkenbell farm raid are pretty fun to do and easy. Especially for the time it takes, it's definitely worth it. Now, everything you earn is straight up profit, so the $500,000 is not a bad thing to get. Now, in the top 5 best businesses, I have the arcade at number 5. A big time saver that I highly recommend everyone to get in the arcade is getting the Master Control Terminal. At this place, you can resupply a lot of your businesses, especially the MC businesses, your nightclub, and even your bunker. You don't want to start the missions from here though, since the cell vehicle will be right at the business. Besides that, you also get a safe in your arcade where you can earn up to $100,000. But the main way to earn money is with the Diamond Casino heist. This is one of the most fun heists in the game, especially the different approaches the game provides, but you do need two players for this to complete it. The agency is a combination of a lot of the previous mentioned businesses, but even better. The payphone hits in the agency are just extremely easy to start and will give you $55,000 for just a few minutes of work. Then besides that, you also get a safe in this business like we got in the arcade, but this one can hold up to $250,000. And then the main way to earn money, which has the biggest payout for $1 million, is by doing the Dr. Dre heist. When you're doing the Dr. Dre heist, it mainly contains out of missions where you will have a lot of fights going on, so it is pretty long, but combining it with the passive income and payphone hits, it's definitely a must-have business. Now, one of my favorite businesses in the game is the asset lab business, because I barely have to be at the asset lab at all. This is because this is the only business where you can actually buy the supplies on your phone. You can simply give Mod a call on your phone and he will handle everything from there. And then eventually, when you have a full product bar, if you sell this, you can always get only one vehicle, which makes selling in public lobbies really easy, which earns you even more money. And then a well-deserved number two is the nightclub. The nightclub has the highest passive income you can earn every day, which is $50,000 every 48 minutes. And besides that, you also have the sell goods. Here you simply attach technicians to one of these options and they will do all the work for you. The only thing that you will have to do is once everything is completely filled up, you just have to sell this and you will earn over $1.5 million. And to no one's surprise, the number one business is of course the Kosetka. Inside the Kosetka, you can start the Kaiperico heist, where you can start the setups, which are easy to complete. But a lot of people waste too much time doing the final heist. That's why I show you in this video how you are able to complete the Kaiperico heist the fastest way possible in just 7 minutes.